हेलो एवरीवन, लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद चैप्टर इंटरनेट ऑनलाइन सर्फिंग एंड टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट गूगल ड्राइव एंड ई कॉमर्स. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. सो फर्स्ट इज व्हाट इज गूगल ड्राइव. गूगल ड्राइव इज अ स्टोरेज स्पेस प्रोवाइडेड बाय गूगल where we can store our files and folders. So what is Google Drive? It is a storage space, it is a free storage space provided by Google where we can keep our data like files and folders there safely. Fine. Now the question arises, why should we store our files and folders there? Because if we keep on storing our data on phones and laptops, so one day the memory will be full. So instead of unnecessary filling the space of your phone and laptop, what we do, we keep our data on Google Drive safely. Fine. So that your phone and laptop memory should be free. Now the second is, the file stored in the Google Drive can be easily sent or shared to other devices. So whatever files you have stored on Google Drive, you can share those files or you can send those files to somebody else. Fine. We can access our stored files from anywhere and at any time. Simple. We can access our stored files from anywhere and at any time. We can edit and make changes to the stored file. So if once you have stored the file, you can edit those, you can make changes on those stored files. We can search our files by using keywords in Google Drive. So in Google Drive, if you want to search your file, so by giving the keywords, you can main words, keywords means main words, by giving the keywords, you can search your files on Google Drive. We get 5 GB free space to store our data and this can be upgraded up to 25 GB. See, Google account get the 15 GB free space, but that 15 GB free space includes Gmail, Google Drive and Google Pics. So that's why I have written 5 GB. 5 GB only for Google Drive. Fine. And we are talking about Google Drive only, not for Gmail and Google Pics. So we get 5 GB free space to store our data and this can be upgraded up to 25 GB. Now we will talk about e-commerce. E-commerce refers to the first full form, electronic commerce. Commerce means buying and selling. So when you buy and sell something on the internet, that is called e-commerce. Okay, let's see. E-commerce refers to the buying and selling of products and services. It can be services also, not only products. Means if you are teaching something online or if you are providing your services online, that means that also includes in e-commerce. So buying and selling of products and services through websites using the internet technologies, this is e-commerce. And it also includes transmitting of funds over the internet. Suppose you purchase something, so you need to pay online, so funds transactions also comes under e-commerce. Whatever you have given the online payment, that also comes under e-commerce. So it also includes transmitting of funds over the internet. Now the different types of e-commerce. First is business to business, business to consumer, consumer to consumer. Business to business means when one company purchases some raw material from another company. Like if a company manufactures a car, so it needs some steel or aluminium or other accessories. So what that company does, company purchase those raw materials and other accessories from other company. So this is called business to business, means between two companies, deal between two companies. Fine. Business to consumer, when we do any shopping, when we purchase anything from website like from Amazon, Flipkart or Amway or Body Shop, when we do any shopping on such websites directly, then that is called business to consumer, between company and consumer. Fine. Consumer to consumer, third type. Consumer to consumer means, suppose you have purchased a refrigerator and after 10, so you become consumer and after 10 years you want to sell that. So if you want to sell that, then you put that product on the website like OLX or eBay, fine. And then another consumer purchased that. So it is a deal between two consumers. So these are the example OLX and eBay of consumer to consumer. So these are the three different types of e-commerce. Now we will see advantages of online shopping. Online stores are open 24/7 throughout the year. You can purchase anytime, in night, in morning, anytime. Fine. So 24/7. We can choose goods that fit our budget. So we can select the goods as per our budget. We can shop both at home and at work. Online stores give more discount because they don't have they don't invest the money in opening the shops, malls, so they don't give that they save that money. That's why they give more discount, because they don't have infrastructure or other expenditures, so that's why they give more discount. So online stores give more discount. There is no need for vehicle and thus fuel consumption is saved. So we don't need to go to the shop or malls, so fuel consumption will be saved. Most important thing is it also saves time. Yes, definitely. If by sitting at home you are purchasing something, you are doing shopping, it will save your time. Now the disadvantages of online shopping. So what can be disadvantages? Items are to be selected within the availability. Yes, suppose you are doing shopping on the any website, so whatever items are available on that, you have to purchase that, you have to select from that only. It doesn't have any interaction with the dealer. Yes, you cannot interact with the dealer for negotiation. Whatever prices are there, prices are fixed, you need to pay that. Sometimes it becomes time consuming as there is confusion in selecting the good. Yes, the booking of an item is totally dependent on the network connectivity. Network connectivity also plays an important role. You cannot touch, see and test the products. And it mainly caters to urban areas. Still in rural areas and remote areas, online facility is not there. Fine. So it mainly caters to urban areas only. So these are the few disadvantages also. Now the online mode of payment. What are the online mode of payments? How can you pay online? So first is debit card. These are the plastic cards. Now it is an online shopping card and it is also used in ATMs to withdraw cash. So this is dual purpose, double purpose. How? Means through debit card you can do shopping as well as you can use in ATMs to withdraw cash. It is issued by a bank and linked with a bank account. Now there is not any magic. Means when you swipe the card, from where the money comes? money comes from your bank account. So if you have bank account, that bank provides you debit card, and you use debit card for the shopping, and that money will be deducted from your bank account. As soon as the card is swiped and we enter our security pin, the money automatically gets transferred from our account to the dealer's account. Fine. Now the credit card. See, both are plastic card. Now what is the difference between credit card and debit card? Debit card we have already discussed. In credit card, first thing is, it is not necessary that the bank from you are getting the credit card, there should be your bank account. Not necessary. So credit card means, actually what you are doing, you are borrowing the money from the bank. So any bank can give you money on credit, but you have to return that money within a grace period, within a given period. If you are unable to return the money to the bank, then the bank will charge a huge interest on that money. So you need to pay the interest also. Fine. So let's see. Credit card can be used for online shopping. It allows us to borrow money from the bank for purchasing any item. Not necessary that in this bank you have bank account. From any bank you can get the credit card, but the bank will check your source of income and your credit report or credit history, whether you return the money on time or not, and what is your source of income, that will be checked. Fine. According to that only the bank will give you the money, and there is a limit also. Fine. So there is a credit limit, means like monthly 50,000, from 50,000 only you can do shopping, you can purchase something. So 50,000 will be your credit limit. Fine. The borrowed money need to be repaid within the grace period of 25 to 30 days. If we pay money back to the bank after the grace period, then the interest is charged on the borrowed amount. So these types of card should not be preferred. Fine. So I hope it is clear. Let's see the next. NEFT, electronic transfer. What is the full form of NEFT? National Electronic Fund Transfer. Suppose you want to transfer the fund from your bank account to some other bank account across the country, means suppose you have you want to transfer the money from your bank account to the bank of Mumbai, so you can transfer the money from your bank to other bank across the country. This is a simple, secure, safe, fast and cost effective way to transfer funds. Bank charges a nominal fee for each transaction. Fine. Cash on delivery. When we are not interested to go for a cashless transaction or don't want to pay in advance, we choose COD option. Suppose you are not interested in paying online, or you don't want to pay in advance, then we choose the COD option, cash on delivery option. In this method, we make the payment only when the goods have been delivered by mail order. If the goods are not paid for, they are returned to the retailer. So these are the advantages for cash on delivery. Fine. Now MICR. MICR stands for Magnetic Ink Character Recognition. See, you might have seen a number below the check that is called MICR code. And the MICR code is of 9 numbers and written with magnetic ink. And to read that number, we need a machine, MICR reader we call it. Basically, MICR reader is used to clear that check. So when the check is read by the MICR reader, or the when the check is further produced to a sensing machine that reads and transfers the amount to the dealer's account. Fine. So when the MICR reads that MICR code, then the money will be transferred to the dealer's account. So MICR code is of 9 number. The first 3 numbers indicates the city, next 3 number indicates the bank, and the last 3 numbers indicates the bank branch code. Fine. So that's it in this video. I hope you have understood. Thank you for watching.